Hello, everybody. I want to thank everyone for joining me. I was just checking out how many new subscribers. $816. Not too bad. About 50 new subscribers this week. Thank you, everybody. Those that have just joined me, I'm going to have another exciting video of opening up a box full of vintage and new sewing machine parts. Let me lower the volume on this. It was about 9 or 10 videos of me unloading a 26-foot truck. Make sure to watch those. And then following that, what was there, about 3 parts. The first part didn't unload, but there was a couple parts of I was unloading the 12-foot truck. And then a video of me unloading the back of my pickup truck. So make sure to watch those videos. And we'll set up this off to the side. Can't wait. Oh, some featured items that members have been watching me open up the boxes. Other people and subscribers. If you're a subscriber on YouTube, it's best to get a hold of me on Facebook. Make sure to join my Facebook groups, and you can either, best way is just send me a personal message with any request. But those that have been watching my videos, I let everyone know, if you see anything you like, to let me know, send me a message. And a lot of people sent me a message on these needles. I'm using the manual focus again. I guess they're good needles. And they come in 5-packs and 4-packs for $10. A lot of them have sold. There's about 6 or 7 left. And these Kenmore cam bags kind of filling up. Anybody know what these go for? They go for a lot of Kenmore. Dollar each. Dollar each on the cam. So those are the specials I'm doing. Those will probably sell out. So let's get right to it. I think I was looking for this. I kid you not. Just a little tension. I was looking for one for a tension assembly part. Unfortunately, it's not labeled. There's some writing, but it's just a date. All right, I'm excited. Let's go ahead and lower the camera. Where's my focus thing here? I'm using the same shuttle to focus with. All right, let's get these boxes out. There's several boxes in a box. Let's see, we've done this enough times to know to stack them on this side and get the camera in focus on that side first. We'll stack them like this. Ooh, what's in the mystery box? Stack them like this. All right. Here we go. I can't wait. To see what's in these things. Let's see. Where did my focus shuttle go? Well, we have to use these needles. About right. All right, we'll start dumping them out. Oh yeah, we got to get the box back up here. We use this box for right this second. I'll put these other boxes in here. All right, here we go. No clue. A Singer brush clutch. Okay. We have the screwdriver bag. The screwdriver poked right through it. There is we'll do another one. A miscellaneous bag. All right. We have a tension assembly. It's all new to me too. I would have had these made out already. So we're just gonna write real quickly. Tension assembly. Alright. Keep them organized. It doesn't say what it's for. We have a belt. I'm just gonna stack them here. I can't just keep organizing them here. What's in this box? I have baggies over here that, look at that. I never see one in a box. They mostly just bobbin winder to some kind of green machine. I wonder if there's gonna be a bunch of those. Might as well make a bag for it, in case I come across a lot of them. Bobbin, winder, assembly. Let that dry a second. Okay. Oh, I should know what this is. I see enough of them. This finger needle plate. Probably a lot of you recognize it. All right, what's in this box? Salvage. PC board. No, don't mean nothing to me. It must be one of them there fancy sewing machines. No clue on that one. Set that aside. That box was almost empty. Let's up. Dump another one out. Get some info down here. Hey, brand new something. Brand new, yes, walking foot. Da-da-da. Check that out. It's a brand new walking foot. This will fit on many sewing machines. Let's see here. This is a low shank, which means it'll fit on your Singer 221, as well as your 66, 99, a lot of old Singers. That'll fit on. How nice is that? The walking foot. Well, gotta do it. I should have brought more baggies. This is the last of the big ones here. You think I'll need a big one? Let's go. Well, I've been going big with all of them, so let's just go walking foot. That's pretty nice. I got two brand new walking foots. All right, we'll put that aside. What do you think's in this box? So far, I'm liking this box. There's a lot of new stuff in here. $26.95. Another walking foot. Ooh. Singer brand. $26.95. That sounds about right, too. Wait a minute. No, it's low. It's a price bit high. Actually, that would be right up for a slant shank. I don't know why, but everything slant shank costs more money. This is about $10 too high. I would say $60.95 on this. So are these. I would say those are $10 too high. And what we got here? It looks like walking foot paperwork, just in case. These look like original paperwork. More walking foot paperwork. We'll just throw with the walking foot. Good thing I put a bag. Oh, this is, what else we got there? Where's my garbage can? Okay. What's in the bag here? What's in the bag? Come on. Be some. Ooh. Look at that. It doesn't. Nothing. No good info on there. Yeehaw! Brand new tension assemblies. You know, I got a couple requests. I'm trying to find the tension assembly. Wait, let me get this right. Morse 4300, I think. So maybe one of those will fit. No clue. Where's the miscellaneous bag? Let me mark this. We'll just abbreviate it. MIS. Real quickly, and then because we got stuff that a washer. Oh, out of focus. Don't know. This is a tension assembly part. We can put that in that bag. This is a needle. I got a thing for needles. We'll just put the loose screws there. We'll get this belt out of the way. Okay, get that out of the way. Miscellaneous. Some more walking foot stuff. Another feed dog. Yay. Oh, good. Singer 604 and a 404. Really? The 404 and the 604 uses the same feed dog, according to this. But you might want to look that up. Okay, so right to it. Let's go. Okay, we're still going. Okay, you guys are crowding my space a little bit. Yeah, let's dump another one out. Oop, there was a foot hiding down there. Alright, paperwork. Purchase order, Viking Way, computerized. Okay. Alright, no clue. Anybody have a clue what these are? Probably too new. I have no clue. They actually have numbers on them. Alright, this is crazy. Bunch of... What? Just... Fuses? Sewing machine uses fuses, huh? A shuttle driver, Viking. Okay. That settles it. Hope I can find the baggie real quick. Nope, good. Got some right here. So, it looks like Viking stuff. And probably newer Viking stuff. Those of you that know a little bit about Viking or looking for some Viking parts. Good time to get it. I don't know much about it. Just ask. Send a picture. Yes, that's a good point too. For those that are making requests. It makes my job a lot easier if you could send a picture of the sewing machine you need parts for. If you can do it. I'm just kind of... I don't know what this stuff is. Fuses. Model 400. I don't know what 400 you're talking about. There's actually a shuttle. So it's looking like mostly Viking... Viking. There is some... Oh, that's from the last bag. Viking. Yeah, this is just... They just had a Viking box. Viking, okay. Alright, well there it is. We just stuff it all in there. Way it came out of there, so... And probably this paperwork probably tells you... Good thing I got big bags. Bought these originally for put the t-shirts in that I sell. I make sewing art, sewing machine art, and I put that art on t-shirts and tote bags. Good bag to put the t-shirts in. Viking. Yay! Yep, don't go too far, bag. I see more Viking stuff.
Check underneath. Where's the money?
No money in that one. We'll keep trying, though.
Bobbins. Do we actually got a bobbin one yet? I don't think so. For the bobbins, I just want to put it like, you know, big old... I want to... If I get a lot of bobbins together, I just want to make some more sewing art with the bobbins. All right, I'm looking at it. Oh, it says Viking. So let's take it, leave it at that. Let's leave it at that. Am I in focus, everyone? I think so. Come on. Okay, Viking bag, you're getting stuffed with crazy products I've never seen. They look like zip ties, but it says Viking on it. Viking zip ties. Well, you know what? Those are Viking bobbins. I'll just put it with the Viking stuff. Viking pressure foot. Let me guess. Viking bobbin cases. Probably, huh? Probably. Viking bobbins. Viking. This one says Singer on it, though. But it's a Singer bag, but it's Viking. That's all they were doing is using some Singer bags. All right. Oh, that whole box was two boxes of Vikings. Oh, boy. Boy, oh, boy, look. This one's stuffed, and it's heavy. Be good. Be not this stuff. Points. I don't need points. Those that's like, make sure that's zipped up. Tension stuff. Ooh, tension studs. Hello. Yeah. Yeah. Studs. Ooh. That's what those are called. Anybody wants to know? It's a Singer tension pressure plate with... I can't read it. But yeah. Cool, cool, cool. Maybe I'll learn a few things. Feed dog. Boy, there's so much organizing. You know, I'm just going to kind of show everybody. I might just put it back in here. And then, you know, later I might just organize it. So let's go through the box here. And we'll just put it right back in the box on this one. So we seen the studs. We have needle plates. Hopefully we can come across some good ones. Model 16. All right. We have a clear two-piece foot, some kind of a tool thingamajigger, the two tiny, tiny screws, needle plate screws. Wow, they just bagged two needle plate screws. Amazing. A cool-looking bobbin case for model 158-1680. I don't understand it, though. What are they talking about? Oh, I know what a 1680 is. It's one of the higher numbers and them. On the Kenmores, when I say higher numbers, you got the 158 point, and you got the 16 series, you know, you got the 12, 13, 14, and then it's those next two numbers, which is 80. And I almost kid you not, I think those higher numbers were experimental machines, because they always did something different with them, so that's probably what that case is for. I don't know. Empty. I don't know, Singer 301, Rob the 301 repair a 221. Really? It's just some kind of bar, nothing good. We have, yes, needle plates. Feels like Kenmore. Yep. They got them hidden in here. They're like wrapped in paper. Let me see if I can feel it. That would be a Kenmore. Let's see here, Singer, needle guides, and another needle plate, 10 more needle plates, and a big old or that looks like some kind of control dial complete, a Singer control dial complete. Wow, there's a lot in this box, and appears to hold bobbin case too tight. Oh boy, with the diagrams and all explanation. about the broken part and a positioning bracket. It says a foot, some kind of old gears. Oh, some more of those. Man, I can't believe it. I know where that goes. We can put that right at the tension assemblies. And then use which foot kit for ankle. I gotta look. I feel like there's a bunch of them in there. They're all hidden. Oh, there are a bunch of feet. There's a bunch of feet in here. Look at that. Snap-on. $8. $8. $8. That's not my price. No way. No way. No how. No way. Too much. All right. Where was I? Did I lose? Oh, I think that was it. But yeah, bunch of feet. Something I don't know. Might as well show you guys something I don't know. They're like, what is it? He don't know. Okay. What does it say? Broken something. And there's a price tag of $4,000.